Hello there, it's Saturday the 25th of June 2016. This is United Kingdom Talk, coming to you from an independent country within Europe. How are you today, boys and girls? We missed you yesterday, didn't we? So I've got a few birthdays to do from yesterday and, of course, today as well. Must apologise, we got the date wrong. At the bottom of yesterday's video, you may have noticed it said the 23rd instead of the 24th. And thank you very much to Jerry for pointing that out to me, who watches the show and immediately, rather pleasing to myself, points out mistakes that I may have made. Sometimes you're kind of driving through the thing and you don't remember things. So thank you very much for that, Jerry. Yes, a small independent country within Europe. That's what we are now, boys and girls, or we will be soon. Now, talking of Europe and all things Europe, boys and girls, now all that commotion going out about money and businesses and this, that and the other and what have you. highlight this morning on many people's Facebook pages. Now, this could be of interest to you. Are you ready? Are you a Eurovision fan? Yes. You didn't think about that, did you? Well, good news, boys and girls. British contestants should continue to appear in the Eurovision Song Contest because eligibility is based on whether national broadcasters are part of the European Broadcasting Union and not the European Union. It's all very confusing, so we can still take part. Isn't that good news? Do you honestly think anyone's going to vote for us? Come on. You think we're going to go in the negative equity, dear. we'll be the only country ever to have minus votes at the Eurovision. But it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter, of course, all the other songs are rubbish anyway. They're just jealous. That's what it is. They're jealous of our wonderful music. Look at what wonderful singers. What we need is Adele to come on the stage or No Erection. We need Adele backed by No Erection. That's what we need. Singing a song. What makes us beautiful? Something along those lines. Nice and bouncy and happy. Not a depressing ballad. Although I do like ballads, don't get me wrong. I like big power ballads. The sort that Barry Manilow does. Maybe the people that run the Eurovision in this country could approach Mr. Barry Manilow to do a song for it. I reckon that would win. There's absolutely no negativity in my small but interesting mind that if Barry Manilow was to enter the Eurovision Song Contest for the United Kingdom, we would win. We would absolutely win. I think that's a good idea, don't you? And it goes on. Amidst another story here, different newspaper. Amidst much more important news, we've seen lots of speculations about the United Kingdom's participation. I like that word. Participation. Four syllables, participation in the Eurovision Song Contest. Rest assured that the British referendum outcome does not impact the BBC's right to participate in the Eurovision Song Contest. If you like the Eurovision theme tune, actually, the best one you'll find is the one that they did in Harrogate in London. And I think, I can't remember his name now. You know, the bloke with a moustache. Ronnie Hazelhurst. I think he arranged it. And it goes, da 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 da. And the little thing spins round and zooms in. Oh, it's wonderful. Look it up. Look up the beginning bit. Eurovision Song Contest. I think it's 1982. Harrogate, the opening bit of the beginning. Oh, it's a wonderful piece of music. So there's the good news for the Eurovision singers, boys and girls. But anyway, onward. I did a couple of new... there were a few people are now doing new songs at our karaoke nights. Excuse me, I've got a little bit of a frog in my throat this morning, probably due to the two songs I did last night. Last night I sang at the karaoke... That's Friday night. Bermuda Triangle. Bermuda Triangle. It makes people disappear. You know that one. And I did. Could it be magic? Come. Come into my life. But actually, I did the Donna Summer version. Did you know Donna Summer did that? Donna Summer did Could It Be Magic as well. So I did those two last night. And we've got new songs from Christopher. Christopher W is in the house. All round cool dude. He used to be a DJ as well. He's a very good friend of mine. We met, I think, would it be the 80s? Maybe very early 90s I met Chris. And he was DJing in like big London clubs. And I was just in the Black Cap. I say just in the Black Cap. In those days, the Black Cap, which is where I worked since from 1989 to 2007, DJing and doing karaoke at a bingo night as well, I did there. In the 80s, and I would say up to about 1990, up to about 2001, that was known as like, you know, that is the place to go, the Black Cap in Camden. And then after that, it kind of started going downhill a bit, unfortunately. I think I met Chris in there, actually, Christopher. And he was DJing at these big clubs. Anyway, he comes along to the karaoke. So there was a gap where we didn't see each other many, many years. And then when he came back into Central Station, I think, where I now work, I've been there, I think maybe just over 2 years or coming up to 2 years, I think. Can't remember. Anyway, so he came back in here. It was so nice to meet up with him again. And it was like I'd never not seen him. Do you know what I mean? With some friends like that, you can just pick up like that where you left off. And it was like, I don't know, 10, 20 years hadn't passed. I've had that before as well. Funny, isn't it? So it's nice to see him. And he's been doing a lot of new songs recently, which I think is wonderful to try new songs. You know, and it doesn't matter. Anyone who tries new songs and sort of veers off what they usually do, sometimes it doesn't work. Doesn't work, you know. And you know sort of within the first chorus and verse that it doesn't work. But that doesn't matter because you tried something new. I think it's absolutely wonderful to try something new, Chris. I really do. And you've been doing so. So I think he's doing, what's the new one he's doing on Monday? The Power of Love, Jennifer Rush. But you're my lady, or you're my man. That one. Power ballad with the Central Station Television Orchestra behind you. Yes. If you want to join us at Central Station, we do karaoke there every Monday night. That's between 8 and 11:30 p.m. with cheap drinks every Monday night. OK, cheap drinks and karaoke on a Monday night. Do you know what? I'm going to keep clearing my throat. So I've got a button here. When I push this, you can't hear me. That's better because that's getting on your nerves. I don't mind doing it twice on the microphone, but any more than that, it starts getting on your nerves, doesn't it? And also on Friday nights between 8:30 and midnight, karaoke at Central Station, Wharfdale Road in King's Cross. All are welcome there, okay? All are welcome. So Christopher did new songs. We also had, it was nice to see Johnny Key there, Mr. Johnny Key. Another all-round good guy. He did a new song last night. Not Splish Splash Posh. What was the other one you did? It was a rocky... Johnny does like rocky, rolly type stuff, which is excellent. And also Little Jack. Now, you sometimes... you will see these people all on our Facebook Live videos. We did another couple last night. And Jack is always on there. Jack always appears in the sort of last third of the night, because I think he's in a restaurant. Jack works in a restaurant, and he's doing lots of Shaking Stevens at the moment, aren't you, Jack? And he was doing dancing as well, not only standing there, you know, because some people sometimes they stand there with a... I'm just looking for a microphone now. I can't... Oh, here's one. Oh, I have to be careful what I picked up. Hang on a minute. I don't want to show you a microphone I'm nicked from somewhere else, do I? Oh. I haven't got one here. Where have I got? I've got the top of a microphone. The trouble with these microphones, if you drop them, this is a new top that I ordered from eBay, and you drop them and that bit gets flattened and it starts affecting the sound. So that's it. Anyway, so some people are like, and other people are dancing away. And Jack is one of those who is dancing away and smiling happily. That's what we like to see. Little smiling, happy faces on the stage wherever you are. So thank you very much, Jack. And Jack always does some new songs as well. So that's great. Last night we had Roy's 71st birthday in there last night. Roy is just such a wonderful, wonderful person and character. He really is. And his favourite song with the punters, sorry, that's the wrong way around. The customer's favourite song of Roy's is If I Were a Rich Man. And he doesn't just sound If I Were. No, he performs it. He performs it. He runs all over the stage. Sometimes he moves out of the camera view, unfortunately. And you're forever trying to move the camera. But he sings that, and it's wonderful. If I Were a Rich Man, la da 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 da. And that is his favourite song with the customers. It really is. So lovely night last night. We did another little Facebook Live test very briefly this morning, only a couple of minutes, because we've had a new Facebook Live update. And, we've had a new Facebook update, so I downloaded it excitedly, thinking, I wonder if they fixed this little problem of the camera being the wrong way around. Because when I do a Facebook Live program, I use the front camera. Now, the reason I use the front camera is because then you can see people's little instant messages coming up at the bottom. If I turn it round, then obviously I can't see the screen. But on the front camera, I'm afraid the problem is still not fixed. In fact, I don't know if they're even trying to fix it, but every time they do something to try and fix it, something else has gone wrong. So now I can't turn. So if I'm doing a Facebook Live video like that, okay, that is okay up there. I can see the messages at the bottom, but on the front camera, it's a mirror image. So if I'm showing you that now, okay, this old Casio calculator, that writing is the correct way round, isn't it? Yep. If I was doing a Facebook Live program with the same camera, on the front camera where the screen is, right, on the phone, that writing would be back to front. You're getting a mirror image. And they still haven't fixed it. Not only that, but now, if I turn the camera around like that, the picture doesn't write itself up. So I'm I look like I've had a stroke now, don't I? I look like that. Oh, please. Someone's going to write in now. Oh, that's not funny. Sam had a stroke. And that's really offensive. Oh, go away. Get a sense of humour, please. We're coming away from all this politically correct stuff soon, you know. Oh, yes, yes, yes. We'll be able to say eventually what we want. We will. Well, I do anyway. The last thing I don't ever want to do is offend someone. If you're a bit oversensitive, that is not my fault, is it? You're a bit oversensitive. Are you a little bit oversensitive? Are you oversensitive? Well, you poor little thing. Let me tell you, when my straight mates come past me, I slap my arse and they say, "Are you all right, you old puff?" I'm not offended. Why would I be offended like that? Lucky you get touched up by one of them. So there we are, still not sorted with the Facebook Live. Disappointed because the first time they bought out this Facebook Live, it worked. It just works perfectly. And then from the first update they did, it's never worked since. Every time they try and fix something else goes wrong. Can't you just roll it back to whatever you was using before? Blooming things it is. I suppose, no doubt, the lovely Shania. I bet her camera's still working all right. Oh, because Shania's got the newest phone, isn't she? Oh, yes. She's got the iPhone SE. Oh, she don't care. She proudly sat there. Oh, it's working on my phone. It's working on my phone, didn't you, Shania? Working on my phone. Shania, I've had this idea. Right, idea. To bring mass to the masses. Do you think our priests would allow us to do a Facebook Live from church? Would that be a good idea? I mean, it would be a good idea for those people that want to watch what goes on in a church. Just set up their little tripod up there. Although I don't think you're allowed to film the Eucharist, are you? I'm not sure about that. There's some reason for that. Not quite sure. There's a little idea. Go and have a go with your Facebook Lives, boys and girls. That's it. Film your lives in full colour, as we are here on Facebook One Colour. Yes, indeed. So that's it. Adam wanted to tell you, I can't remember if I've told you now, Adam the plumber, who came to the Barry Manilow concert on Thursday, I am now using Catsand Pink. You're probably wondering what that is. That is cat litter. Cat litter. Cat sand pink, which is seems to have cured most of the problem of stones brewing all the way across the kitchen floor. Although the other day, I come in the other night. Oh, she had done a smelly one, dear. Oh, I opened the door. Oh, oh God. Oh, the stench of cat dirt was coming out of my kitchen. I opened all the windows and doors. This is 2 o'clock in the morning. Oh, it stank. Dirty old cow she is. But it wasn't all over the kitchen floor, fortunately. Oh, it did smell. Why is it that sometimes cat dirt smells really bad? And other times it's quite, you know, it's never pleasant. But it's not too... Oh, I don't... Oh, I'm feeling sick now. Oh, what's the time? I've got to go up to water aerobics. Don't want to be late for that. I've got to leave about... What time have I got to leave for that? Oh, is it 11 o'clock? I might have left that a bit late. Actually, oh, it's all right. I join in halfway. I go to water aerobics now on a Saturday. I think it's either 11 or 12 o'clock. I can't remember now. If it's 11 o'clock, if I'm late, all the old birds will start with, oh, you're late, and all this old business. Thank you very much. Let's do some birthdays. Now, we've got a couple of birthdays to do, I think, haven't we? Because there was yesterday's, which we've missed. We'll do today's first. Happy birthday to Dean. All round good dude, Dean. Dean, you keep putting rude things and swearing on my wall. I do have to remove them, dearly. Do remember there is a family audience watching this programme. Children and families from all over the world are watching this to see what it really is like here in the United Kingdom. Land of hope and glory. Da 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 da. Yes. Happy birthday to Dean, 51-year-old. Watch what you're putting on my wall, please. Happy birthday to day two. Let me see. I'll just do the faces that I recognised straight off. I think. Oh, who's that there? I think I recognise. Is that? Little Trevor. Hello, Trevor. Oh no, that's a different Trevor. No, don't recognise you, so I'm not doing it. Here we go. Here's some more here. Happy birthday to Carl Royce, who's 41 yesterday. And Carl used to come to Hammersmith Belushi's, didn't you, my friend? And you'd have a dance there. I think, are you married now? You're either married or you're just about to get married. So happy birthday to my very good friend Carl, who I haven't seen for a couple of years now. Oh, no, the last time I saw you, I think, was in that other place in Hammersmith, which has gone there, the Lorry Arms. I think they've renamed that now, haven't they? If I remember rightly. Happy birthday, sir. Happy birthday to my very good friend, Aaron John, who is a top London, young, pretty, good-looking drag queen. Happy birthday, Aaron. 30 today. Oh, my God, you're so old, dear. You're so old. Aaron and I work together a few times a year, generally at Central Stage, and we do have a laugh there, don't we, Aaron? We have a laugh before and after the show in the dressing room, we do. Happy birthday today to Thomas Fernandez. Oh, I like that surname. Fernandez, 21 today. Happy birthday, Thomas. Happy birthday to Kunal Chugs. I think it's Chugs. Happy birthday, sir. Elliot James Begley. Happy birthday, 22 today. Lots of youngsters today. Oh, why do you want this old bloke sitting here to sing you happy birthday? I don't know. Nicola Clancy, happy birthday, my darling. James Palmer, happy birthday to... Oh, I've just lost my thing now. Oh, dear, it's all gone wrong. 1 minute. James Palmer, 1 minute. I've lost my... there it goes, it's back going. What was the date yesterday? 25, 24, 25. There was one more on the end. And Philip Holden. Ah, yes. Philip Holden, happy birthday to you, sir. Lots and lots of wonderful birthdays today and yesterday. Here we go. I can pretend I'm playing a piano. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, lovely people. Happy birthday to you. All right. Hope you have a nice time today, boys and girls. And good luck to those people going to Pride today as well in London. I think there's one in Northern Ireland as well. So if you're going to either of those events, have a wonderful time. I've actually got a night off today. I've got a day off and a night off. Not sure what I'm going to do today. I'm still waiting for someone to ask me to come and see Independence Day. I want to go and see Independence Day. I think it's Independence Day Resurgence, isn't it? I should probably go to the... what's the one? The one with the comfortable seats. Showcase Cinema in Winnersh, which is about 15 minutes drive just down the road to me. Nice big car park, really comfortable seats. Finally today, are you chaps buying any of your ladies' handbags, or maybe you're buying one for yourself, dear? Aaron, you could do with a new handbag on that stage, dear. That other one you had the other week was looking a bit battered, dear. A bit battered. How about this then? Going on. World's dearest handbag at £206,000. I actually don't think this is the world's dearest one. I'm sure there are ones that are dearer than this. Look at this. I mean, it's very plain, isn't it, dear? Is that a colour photo? It is. Looks like, I thought it was a black and white photo first. Not much on that, is it? It says, the handles are two rolled leather handles, slightly longer on travel versions to allow the bag to be carried on the shoulder. The leather, rare albino Nile crocodile skin, probably farmed. Poor crocodile. Do you need to be carrying around bits of animals with you, boys and girls? Honestly, dear. To enhance the creamy white and grey to emulate the Himalayas. The lighter the skin, the pricier the bag. Oh, I'd be very expensive. All us white people are very expensive, dear. That's what it says here. I'm only quoting the paper. How expensive would I? I might not be as expensive as very white people because I've got a slight brown tinge, haven't I? No, it's not dirt. How rude are you? It's not dirt. I've got a nice little brown tinge. I tan very easy. We like to be brown, don't we? We like to be brown. Birkin bags come with a padlock and keys. I often wonder why they bother putting little padlocks and keys on people's handbags. They're so easy to break in, aren't they? I mean, I've nicked hundreds of handbags in my time. I've got a whole wardrobe of them behind me there. No, I do wonder why they put locks on handbags. It's a bit of a waste of time. And it goes on, but £206,000. It says it's a timeless piece of art. It's just a bloody bag, isn't it, dear? It's just a bag. Oh, dear. But my niece reliably informs me whenever I say, oh, I don't know what to get your mum for birthday, or what do you want for your birthday? And I'm like, I was going to get another bag. And my niece says women can never have enough bags. Is that right, girls? What are you putting in all these bags, dear? There's me, you know, going out there, wallet in one pocket, mobile phone in the other, and car keys. That's all you need, dear. You open some of these bags and they've got half the bloody kitchen sink and it's all in there. Tablets for this, bit of makeup there, this, that and the other. Oh, with the lipstick, you know, while they're driving. You've seen these girls driving along, one hand on the steering wheel, this one. Like that, aren't they? Anyway, that's it today. Thank you very much, boys and girls. It's been wonderful to talk to you on this Saturday. I shall see you again soon and have a lovely Saturday, right? Cheerio.